Are you aggressively mining for planeswalker points, or are you just looking to return to the ranks and play Magic on the big stage? Either way, waste not your chance to come to Grand Prix Salt Lake City this September 5th through 7th, hosted by Cascade Games and ChannelFireball.com. Play Magic 2015 sealed in the main event, or enjoy our side events and seminars, including a sealed deck seminar by two members of Team Channel Fireball, former Player of the Year Josh Utter-Layton and Magic Luminary David Ochoa. And if you like playmats, there are many ways to earn the exclusive Grand Prix Salt Lake City playmat featuring the art from Quickling. There's no Saturday registration, so don't act on impulse. Plan ahead by pre-registering at gpsaltlake.com.
How's it going, everybody? Today we're going to change things up and do some M15 drafts. Won a few Vintage Masters drafts, so clearly I'm ready for that format. So Community Cup, here I come. But moving into this pack, I have actually never opened Nissa. So I'm pretty excited to be able to play the Planeswalker. Probably worth a bunch of tickets too. It is the most expensive Planeswalker in real life. I believe we sell it for like $50 or something. Anyways, other cards to look at in this pack are Lightning Strike and Raise the Alarm. Had we not opened the Nissa, Lightning Strike would be what I would take first, and then Raise the Alarm. But we opened Nissa, and that ALs. Yeah, this guy seems pretty sweet. Might even play a Darkshire Citadel, just because. But probably not. I'm not exactly sure how good this Nissa is, but if you can get to that ultimate, man, is it great. Alright, so heading into this pack. So we pass the Lightning Strike and Raise the Alarm. Don't really have to put that in consideration too much. You know, early on, you just kind of want to take the best cards in the pack. So looking at this, I'm looking at Selfless Cathar, Pegasus, but Seraph of the Masses, which I believe is better than Cathar and Pegasus if you wanted to go green-white. A lot of times green-white, you end up drafting like a more of an aggressive deck. But if the best card in green is probably Invasive Species, which keeps us on color, but Seraph of the Masses is really powerful. It's like a flying siege worm, basically. And then we have Quickling, which is also pretty decent, but blue is a worse color than white. So I think I'm going to take the Seraph of the Masses here. I think it's the most powerful card in this pack. But I can certainly see somebody taking an Invasive Species to stay on color or a Quickling. I've not really drafted blue-green that much, though. I do know that green-white is one of the better color combinations in this format, though. So had we taken the Quickling, we would have taken a Welcome Turn. But given that this is where we're at now, no green cards here. There's a Juggernaut, which is decent. But I've actually been slightly underwhelmed by the card. It's certainly a safe card, and you usually end up playing it a lot of the time. But I'm just going to go ahead and take in a Johnny's Primate here. It's early enough where you know, taking this allows us to prioritize stuff like Sun Grace Pegasus, and even if we have a lot of Convoke, like even Soul Menders will end up making the cut. So I'm going to take the Johnny's Primate here. I'm hoping that at some point there's like this, you know how there's like the white is being overdrafted thing? What if it's to the point where everybody's like, yeah, white's overdrafted, so I'm not going to draft white. And then white becomes open. Is that too deep? Yeah, that's probably too deep. So it's really strange. So I don't know what the guy passed to me. Green is definitely not open. Well, it's not definite, but we have not seen a good green card so far. But I'm just going to go ahead and take the Kinsbale Skirmisher over to Swiftclaw. Now, going into this format, a lot of times, I think naturally I'd be inclined to take the Swiftclaw over to Skirmisher. But as almost all of you know by now, one toughness is not where you want to be in this format due to a plethora of ways to deal with it. I mean, Raise the Alarm, Crippling Blight, Fester Gloom, Forge Devil, blah, blah, blah. So I would much rather have a guy with two toughness. Alright, so what do we have here? We have a Reclamation Sage, a Selfless Cathar, and a Shaman of Spring. I don't really care for the Shaman of Spring in this type of deck. It's better in maybe more of a a mid-rangey green-black deck. I think for me, the pick is between Selfless Cathar and Reclamation Sage. Reclamation Sage is actually pretty decent. You know, the one toughness isn't great, but it is very it's utility, and you'll always main deck it. And I think I want to take that over something like a Selfless Cathar. I feel like if you want, you can end up with a few Selfless Cathars in your deck, whereas it's a lot harder to pick up something like a Reclamation Sage for your deck. And maybe green's just not been opened, and we're trying to cut off green a little bit as well. Here, there's nothing that's that great. There's like a Nimbus of the Isles or Tinker if we wanted to move to blue, but they're not powerful enough for us to consider doing that. I think I'm just going to go ahead and take a Hunt the Weak here. It's pretty clunky, but still gets the job done if you really, really need a removal spell. Alright, so what I want to take here. We have Rune Call Bearer, Soul Mender, and Titanic Growth. I'm not going to take the Soul Mender here. We can get some of those later. It's between Rune Clobber and Titanic Growth. I think I'd rather just fill out the curve with my low drops and then get like a combat trick later. Like here, we'll just take a Titanic Growth now. And I'll take a Solemn Offering as an additional disenchant effect for the sideboard. So this is looking okay. You know, outside of the Nissa and the Seraph of the Masses, it's fairly average deck. Ooh, well, there's a Cathar. But definitely some potential. Hopefully we cut off enough white cards that we get hooked up in the next pack. Or, you know, just open Triplicate Spirits. Don't even worry about that. But, yeah, had we not opened the Nissa, this would just be like, it's probably a slightly below average green-white deck. Take the foil, because foil. Pretty sound reasoning, I would say. So Hunt the Weak is not really at its best in the green-white aggro deck, so there's definitely a possibility that doesn't make the cut. At the same time, given that you're green-white, you have not that many removal spells. A lot of your plays are tempo based, so if we really, really need a removal spell, we can play it. The thing is, we can still end up with cards like Living Totems and Netcaster Spiders and Siege Worms and stuff like that to make the Hunt a Weak definitely a playable option. Yeah, I'm looking for Siege Worm, Raise the Alarm. Any of those cards. Triplicate Spirits, obviously. But, like, we're obviously not that lucky. Can't open a good card to save our lives. Ignore this one. Haha. Alright, so the bottom card is red, unfortunately. Ooh, excuse me. Wow, so this is like an insane pack, but not for us. There's a Murklurker and a Nightfire Giant, which are none of the colors that we're in. There's an Infernal Fist and a Covenant of Blood. So this is just the insane green-black-red pack. There's nothing really worth getting with Heliod's Pilgrim, so I don't think I want to take that either. There is a Speculative Mass Calcify. If we can prioritize white creatures and take that, or we can take something like a Charging Rhino. I don't really like Mass Calcify very much. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and take the Charging Rhino. Like, it's not a great card by any means, but we have a Hunt the Weak. It makes that a little bit better. It gives us another Fatty, which we only have one of right now, so we'll go ahead and take that out of this pack. Once again, very unexciting pack, for us at least. Inferno Fist, Jason's Ingenuity are pretty strong. Kaboomus is okay. For us, it's between like Venom Sliver, Pillar of Light, and Hunt the Weak. And I think I'm just going to take a Pillar of Light. Hunt the Weak can be a little clunky, and I don't want to overload on them on the 4-drop slot, especially because there's a bunch of other random 4-drop that we could play. So having one of each seems okay. Alright, so we are just... feels like... yeah. We're going to end up more mid-range than anything. There's an Ulcerate here and a Borderland Marauder, so... those are obviously cards that we don't want, and not really seeing anything else. I think we're going to get some green in this pack. Maybe not the white, though. There's an Ancient Silverback here, but I think I'd rather just have a 3-drop. He is pretty large, though, but he's kind of slow. And we already have a Rhino and the Seraph, and we want a 3-drop, so I'll take the Sentinel. Can randomly block flyers and get over and whatnot. Ooh, that's pretty lucky. All right, pretty happy about that. Siege Worm, very, very good. We're not wide enough where Sanctified Charge is a bomb anymore. I think we're just going to be, like I said before, more of like the mid-range green-white deck where Hunt the Weak's actually not that bad. Here we have another unplayable pack. I'll take a Mark by Honor. I think it's better than Oppressive Rays. Geez, there was a Venom Sliver in the draft, so I'm going to happily take a Constricting Sliver here and hope to table the Venom Sliver, because it doesn't look like we're going to be the super aggressive deck anymore. All right, really happy about that. Seder Wayfinder is great if you have Convoke cards, and right now our deck is fairly mana hungry, so I think I'm going to take that. I don't need another Golem here. We just need something that allows us to Convoke and helps us find the lands, and that's what this does. Living Totem is also fine, but Wayfinder is where it's at. All right, and here, Midnight Guard is okay, but I like Living Totem a lot, so I'm just going to go ahead and take him. Here, I'll take the Heliod's Pilgrim in case we get like a Spectral Ward or something, I guess. Could put this guy here. He's more of a 3-drop, right? We have a bunch of 2s. This guy here, yeah, see, our curve doesn't look so bad now. I really want like Elvish Mystics and things like that. Nidcaster Spider, ways to survive so that we can cast like our powerful creatures like Sagewyrm, Seraph, Sliver, and Nissa. And this definitely looks like a deck where I'd prefer to have a Soul Mender over something like a Selfless Cathar. Helps us survive to the late game, and we have a Pride Mate. Here. Take a Hot Soup. This could randomly be boarded in if you need a way to kill them. Take a Vine Weft. Could have taken like a Radiant Fountain or whatever. Yeah, combo with this. We actually have, and I might play it now that we have the Seder Wayfinder. Oops, we definitely want to keep this in the deck. We have a Sliver Hive that we randomly took. So if we get the Venom Sliver, definitely jamming it into the deck. Highly unlikely that we get it, but crazier things have happened. Yeah, we can easily cut this Charging Rhino if our curve ends up getting too high. Definitely the worst of our more expensive drops. There's nothing wrong with playing like one Selfless Cathar if you have a lot of Convoke creatures. Although we only have 2 right now. Ooh, foil Tormod's Crypt or this guy? I'll take the Tormod's Crypt. It's foil. Alright, so we got a reasonable amount of green out of that pack. The Wayfinder was nice, Totem and Siege Worm and Constricting Sliver, so we did okay for ourselves, but feels like the guy we passed to were, in one of our colors. Yeah, I don't know if I play Sliver Hive with the Constricting Sliver. If our mana is not good enough, like, probably can't support it. But if we pick up another Constricting Sliver or, like I said, a Venom Sliver, I'll probably run it.